the unification. Everything that has come together to be at a place like this right now, and having the chance and the opportunity to be there.
I remember we had a really long journey traveling via the UK, traveling via India, and eventually we arrived in Kathmandu.
Hey, dude.
Tell me, what happened? Why are you an hour late?
Why? Because Milan wanted to go to the bathroom and make himself look really smart. And that's the truth, actually. That is the truth. But it's cool to be here. It really is amazing.
What's all this here?
This is all our stuff. This is 200 kilos of equipment. 200 kilos.
I brought you something to welcome.
Look at this. Hawaiian.
Yes, here you are.
Hawaiian feeling.
The one for you.
Hey. Yeah.
Strike today and tomorrow and the day after as well. So actually, it's quite quiet on the streets. Most shops are closed. Only by special permission we could arrange a car to pick you up. It's not as nasty as it sounds, just everything is shut down. Maybe it's a good way to get used to Kathmandu before really everything starts, the hell breaks loose.
I received an email from Harry, and he explained to Kevin and me that he was thinking, or he just got a client, and he was thinking about making a documentary about Everest. So if we were interested in that, and if we could join as producers, cameramen, and could set up the whole documentary around it.
In our production, there was two of us. We had to rely totally on each other. Milan had certain skills that he could bring to the mix. I had certain experiences and skills that I could also bring to the mix. And together, we just basically totally relied on each other.
And in a few hours' time, we're going to be picking up Thomas, who's flying in from Abu Dhabi. So it'll be really nice to see him.
Hey guys, good seeing you. Arrived safely?
Excellent.
Yeah, it's a bit
sorry for the delay, yeah?
Yeah,
so I got a little bit grounded, but other than that, it was perfect.
Thomas is a German guy who lived in Abu Dhabi and worked in Abu Dhabi. And he had a special eye condition. Several years ago, he had a surgery. Everything went well, the surgery was perfectly and everything was healed well. But he noticed that every time when he was climbing after the surgery is that he lost his vision, or everything went blurry or lost his colors when he got above 4,000 meters. So he always dreamt about climbing Mount Everest and thought, now I have this problem, I still want to have that challenge. And so he contacted Harry, and eventually he got involved, and we went together to the mountain.
We got the crampons here, which the airlines lost, and so we're all set. A nice thermos here to keep us nice and warm here as we climb up.
Hello! I wanted to welcome everybody to this brilliant group we have here. This is really a great group, not just in numbers, but also in quality. I would like to wish everybody a safe and especially joyful climb. And I would love to see everybody back here in 2 months, so we can sign the wall together. And just have fun. And this is to a great climb. Cheers.
Cheers.
And we were in a really nice restaurant in Kathmandu. And I leaned opposite the man who was directly opposite, a man called Lincoln, who was from Australia. And I said to him, you know what, Lincoln? There's 20 people at this table. And he went, yeah, so? You can add up. I went, well, do you know that 10% of people that climb Everest never make it back? And then he just went grey. And he went, that's two people at this table going to die. I went, yeah. And he went, Thanks, Kevin.
Well, Thomas.
Early morning hours.
Back out.
Back out. Ready to go. Bye-bye, Kathmandu. Welcome, Everest.
You know, getting to Everest is almost half the journey. Because not only, obviously, do you have to fly, you know, for hours and hours, but you have to do a massive land journey. Now, we were climbing on the North Face. We were climbing on the Tibetan side. And that meant an incredibly long road journey.
We're currently heading towards the Chinese border. I think we're about 50 kilometers short of the Chinese border. And hopefully we will get there sometime soon.
Nice shot, Kevin. Very nice shot. You're practicing, huh?
The ride was great, yeah. rough and great. Scenery, superb and gorgeous.
We are at the border post, Kodari. Fill out an embarkation card, departure. We're close to the Friendship Bridge, just a few hundred meters more. Official border, and a kilometer further on is the customs.
Sherpa Kekstra, Sherpa Weeper.
Left early this morning. No problems whatsoever, very smooth ride. Also on the bridge, custom clearance, no problem whatsoever. Friendly people in Nepal, in China. So hope it stays like that and we will have a very good expedition.
Harry accepted Thomas as a client because he really felt the need to prove also that even with a disease that Thomas had, or condition that Thomas had, you still can do many things. It's not like your life is stopping at that moment. There are many things possible, and even climbing Mount Everest.
We're in Nealam. I just received a menu from this nice lady. I'm still in doubt between copy the hand, the big bowl, the small bowl, maybe the nourishing chicken, or clip the sand meat. The tomato fish sounds really nice. The rice line of sand. But I'll probably go back to the good old return to a pot of meat.
Time. Yes, 14th. 14th of April. 16 hour and 20 minutes local time, Beijing time. One country, one time zone. We are here in Nealam, 3700 meters. We're going out for a stroll now to see everybody is a little bit fit, maybe acclimatized a bit. So, we go up.
On the one hand, we acclimatize here to really get the body adapted to the altitude. But even more, we try to test out what's happening to the site. Overall vision, I could still see the rough shapes, but I started to stumble the one or the other time. But it is a good experience, so we know what to expect as we climb higher. And I guess it's also good for the overall team, so they know what impact it may have by walking up, walking down, as to the speed and the certain reactions.
We're waiting to leave now. We're waiting to leave this area. To be honest, I'm quite glad to get out of here now and head on to our next point. Quite interestingly, we actually drive to 5,200 meters and then we get out and take our tourist photographs. But I'm sure when we get out of the bus, we're really going to feel feel the difference of 5,200 meters, even though that'd be for like 10, 15 minutes.
I'm unable to keep any food, so I had to vomit, and so we have to take steps slowly and easily. I'm happy that no headache while being up, but no food for a day is becoming an issue.
We're at the gate of the Sagarmatha Chomolungma National Park. Check our permits here. It's now 4,400 meters. Some sick people in the group. But we'll get them to base camp, and then Dr. Andre can treat them. He's a miracle doctor. Once we give the patients to him, they should be okay very soon. I think we're leaving. So apparently everything's okay. No problem.
I guess there's a few places on the planet that I've been to where you arrive there and you go, oh my God, this is Everest Base Camp. And we drove there in midst of a really heavy snowstorm. And I got out the bus and thinking, my God, you know, this is real, this is Everest. And just as I thought that, Alex, our expedition leader from Russia, came up to me as I was holding a camera and went, welcome!
This is Everest. Everest!
This is Everest.
It's real Everest. You can see.
And I thought, absolutely it is. Yeah, you know, every cliche about Everest, storms, winds, snow, this is what it was. This was Everest.
You see again.
This is a doctor. Our doctor.
No, I used to be a doctor. Now I'm a professional mountaineer. My name is Andrei Silivanov. And also I'm manager of ABC.
But that first moment in arriving at Everest Base Camp really, really summed up what we were going to take on. This was going to be a true adventure on an amazing mountain.
Welcome to Base Camp.
Thank you. You too.
The weather is absolutely terrible. It's a blizzard and it's about minus 10. The problem is that we've all come from sort of hotel environments, and all our main gear, all our Gore-Tex, all our heavy down stuff, all our sleeping bags are all outside in this blizzard. I think people were hoping that we could kind of gradually settle in, but this is a bit of a nightmare. It's nice and warm in here though, but outside it's just blowing a blizzard. Whew, what an arrival. Is this a taste of things to come?
Banana, banana.
Put your wife in there. Put your wife in there.
It's a big puzzle. It's like, I don't know, maybe 100 different parts of steel like this, which have to be fit together.
it's quite interesting.
Hi, Kevin. How's it going?
I'm good. How are you?
Well, I'm on the improving slope, I guess. So the past 2 days were pretty bad, so I couldn't eat and hold anything. So things are improving, and I hope it continues like that over the coming days. And so we're back to normal.